shall be celebrated in the name of
Jesus. Hallelujah!
You know, when we are speaking to, when I was prophesying to her, we just started waving, smiling. You know, someone told me when they saw this, they said, how can you prophesy people and you are just smiling with them? Am I the Holy Ghost? I'm not the Holy Ghost. I just do as I'm led. Others may be doing it their own way. I will do it as led by the Holy Ghost. Amen. Prophecy is not entertainment. No. Prophecy is changing destinies.
Amen.
And I said, by the power of the Holy Ghost, if I be a man of God, favor, and we pray for favor, what happened?
Amen.
She obtained favor. I said, by the power of the Holy Ghost, your husband will get a job that he did not apply for, and the husband got a job that he did not apply for. Number 7 speak of perfection. If you are coming with Jesus, you can do better.
Oh, yeah.
Number 7 speaks of perfection.
Oh, yeah.
Number 7 speaks of completeness. That's God is completing someone tonight.
Yeah.
This morning, those who say you amount to nothing by this encounter, they will come and celebrate you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I keep hearing something as well now. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You want to hear some music. You know, I always believe that those who were born in July.
Amen.
I believe that God created the heavens and earth in July.
Amen.
And then he rested. So he created those who were born in July. He rested during that month.
Yes.
So he created plus me. He created us into rest. Does that make sense?
Amen.
That's what is in the Bible. That was always my belief. But I discovered that that's not what it is. Anyway, let's be more serious now. There is someone in here. Your birthday is this July.
Amen.
If you're born in July, stand up, let's celebrate you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey, God space, all of you are blessed in the name of Jesus. For those who just came here for the first time, this is how we pray. Don't expect to see fire. This is how we operate and things be happen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God is not stereotype. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Many of us, what we do is that we put God in the box. We say because it happened to him like that, that's how it happened to me. God does not operate like that. They say when you start ministry, you'll be for 7 years before it grows.
Nah. Mm-hmm.
That's not my Bible. That's not in that Bible. God does not operate. You can start tomorrow. Be a champion.
Oh, yes.
I said everyone in this ministry is a champion.
Oh, yes.
I said the day I mess up, you'll take the mic.
Oh,
that's God. He's not a respecter of person, he's a respecter of principles.
Oh, yes.
What you want, he wants you to do, he'll bless you.
Amen.
That's why Isaiah 1:19 says that if they are obedient, what will happen? They'll eat the best food of the land. Best food. So they'll drive in the best cars.
Yes.
When the best things are out, they'll call them, come and try this.
Amen.
If they are obedient. Hallelujah.
Amen.
All of you are blessed when God is speaking to someone specifically. Your birthday is next week, Wednesday.
Some of them don't even know their birthday.
Anyone in here that was born on the book of standing? It is next week, in the middle of the week. Wednesday is one of those days. If you are born on the 12th of July, you born on the 12th of July. Come on, then. The rest of you can sit down. Are you clapping for Jesus? You know, I said to someone today, I said, I don't like to prophesy to those who are looking. The last Holy Ghost fire night, when God gave his number, someone said, Pastor, leave that thing. That you know him. So that number, he surely took his phone and looked at the number. That's what someone said.
Yeah.
Wow. Do I even know the color of your phone?
No,
even as I speak, I don't know the color of his phone.
Even me, I was surprised because that number, I know it often more than 20 years.
We only meet on this Holy Ghost fire night. My number sometimes I don't even remember. My wife's number sometimes I don't even remember. You see, it's only in church that they are doubting Thomas's.
Come on.
People go to the herbalist and when they tell them something, they so believe. They go to the doctors and say, take this medication morning, afternoon, evening. If they say 12 o'clock, 11:45, they are standing in water waiting to take that medication. It's only when you come to church and they say, pray this prayer morning, afternoon, evening, you say, Pasito, did I kill Jesus? It is only in church that everything is tolerated. I understand that they are fake prophets, but they are also true prophets. As a matter of fact, God told me very clearly that in the next 3-4 years, I am raising a generation of champions.
Amen.
That will take over city.
Amen.
My God. And there will be people whom you never thought would be amount to anything. There will be people who the society has relegated to the background. There will be people who their families have rejected. Nobody knew Elijah. Nobody. 1 Kings 16, nothing was talked about Elijah.
Oh, yes.
He came out in 1 Kings 17 and he said, King is going to reign now. Prepare yourself. How can a man from nowhere, we don't know his mother, we don't know his father, and he just came out and began to command the king? Because while others were eating ice cream, he was separated. While others were eating, the goose soup, he was separated. He said, I will not make that mistake. I will take cities. I'll change it, my generation.
Oh, yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. If I say congratulations, it's not that something is going to happen. No, it is that something is already happening.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
But it is your faith. The Bible says that it is impossible to please God when you have no faith.
Oh, yeah.
Let me ask a question. Have I ever met you? You sure we have not seen somewhere? You sure we have not seen? You sure you have not spoken to my wife or anyone? My wife, have you ever spoken to me about her? Yeah, you don't know her, but you've spoken to her on the phone.
Oh, okay. All right.
You've spoken to her on the phone. Maybe because she's probably never met you, you spoke on the phone. So she probably not seen the person. She never met you, right? Hallelujah.
Amen.
We've spoken on the phone, but she's never met her. I'm not the kind of person who goes to my wife and say, my wife, what did you discuss with this person? Know me. And if I've ever talked to you about prophecy, what you told me, I will not even prophesy to you. Why not? Why would I prophesy to you? Because we discuss every time. Every word a prophet speaks is a prophecy.
Yes.
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Every word that a prophet says is a prophecy. God said to me, as a matter of fact, today, say, just go there and release prophetic declaration. He gave me Ezekiel 37:7. I prophesy as I was commanded. Say, just release them and they will receive their blessing. Hallelujah. So are we sure, before you waste this time, are you sure that you're born on the 12th of July?
Yes, sir. When was I born?
12th of July. Okay, because you're wasting time now, we're asking for why you're wasting time. So some people will watch now and say, someone connected her on the camera to come outside. That's the world. And who are those talking? Christians. We live in a generation where a pastor is a pastor's enemy. A Christian is a Christian's enemy. When Muslims, why Muslims are so successful? Because they are so united.
Oh, yes.
A Muslim just see if they have a brother who is suffering, they will join their heads and make sure he stands. Oh, yes. But a Christian, once they know that anyone is suffering, they will make sure you die again. But yet we are the ones who are called to take over.
Oh, yes.
I pray that as you leave this place today, God will be releasing an empowerment to take cities in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know about you, but Wolverhampton belongs to where I belong in this room.
Amen.
They will not sleep until they hear the voice of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I hear Fosu. Fosu.
Hey.
Did you tell me that at all? You sure you did not tell somebody who told you? Hallelujah. We have to ask, you see, for the benefit of doubt of everyone here. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Folks, so where is that name from? Is it from West Province?
No.
West Province. Talk loud, let's get it.
Western Province, yes.
Hallelujah.
Hey.
As you were coming, I saw his casket. And I was asking, what am I seeing? Where is your father?
Hallelujah.
Are you clapping for Jesus? Are you clapping for Jesus? No. You have to be very sensitive tonight. Because the enemy is not powerful, he's only strategic. I'll tell you some things now that you yourself, you can't remember. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who is Gustav B?
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Why am I seeing you in Bali? Why am I seeing you in Bali?
Hey!
Tell me that. Did someone tell me that? Mavis, did you tell me that?
No.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah, I put like, I feel like worshiping God. Give us a song.
Amen.
God said, I tell her, she told you that your time has gone.
Amen. Amen.
In heaven and the rain. Oh, power belongs to you.
Power belongs to you.
Power belongs to you.
Power belongs to you.
A prophecy for one is a prophecy for all.
Amen.
What has she got to do with June?
Amen.
The face of June.
Hallelujah.
Are you clapping for June like that? God is now interested in your case.
Amen.
You choke and I bless right now.
Amen.
This one will wipe your tears.
Amen.
This one will marry God in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Father, as if that was not enough, they destroy your marriage. You might think that is just natural what happened. I know. Give her the microphone. Can you confirm what I'm saying? I see someone who is going forward and there is a force bringing you back. But as I speak, as a servant of Jehovah Nissi, a servant of Yeshua HaMashiach, those involved are dying for your sake in the name of Jesus. I don't like that amen at all. If you are not anointed to kill witches, you don't belong to this kingdom. The Bible says that their hearts are still like an iron. So no matter the prayers you pray for them, you're wasting your time. They made up their mind. Have you known yet? Witches who kill their children. A mother killing their children. That's why the Bible says, suffer not the witch to live. Because if you spare him, you are in trouble. None of us shall fall in that trap in the name of Jesus. I always give them a time. I say, I'll pray for you to repent within this time. If you don't repent after that time, you die in the name of Jesus. Okay, you don't answer, amen.
Amen.
A young girl who set herself up to be different. Who set herself up to be distinguished? Studied and all that. But the powers from the foundation are fighting her. What is Banjo? Banjo.
That's my father's name.
Jesus.
I'm really so angry anyway. There's an ancestral power. Your father's really that killed your father and has destroyed your marriage. And I have this to tell you, I'm not talking long, I'd like to see you after. So we talk. The man you left, you separated me, that's your God ordained husband.
It's not the
Amen.
Was doing was manipulated. It's not him. It's not him. You might blame him all you like. The Bible says that if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? Not the unbelievers, the righteous, you and I. The foundation is faulty. Every error in your life is corrected by this encounter in the name of Jesus. As well, if I can see the two of you, I'll be fine. That's one of the mandates of the ministry, to restore marriages. No matter what happens, we'll sit down and God will give us a lady. Even you, in your heart of heart, you know that he's the one. But because of what has happened, it is a man that did it. Does that make sense? But because a man did it, God has sent me to undo it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thing that they may have shot against their marriage, I return it back to send them by fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Wherever they are monitoring you and your husband, your ex-husband, as a remote control in that West province, Banjo. I've never been there.
You see, I've never been there. I don't even know where it is.
Every altar speaking against you then catches fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I'm speaking to everyone here.
Amen.
Every altar. manipulating anything that concerns you. That altar catches fire in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't like that. Amen.
Amen.
Let me pray for you. Father, in the name of Jesus, stretch your hands to heaven. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, oh Lord, you revealed to redeem. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, every spiritual barricades, every rational mountains, oh Lord, that they may have placed on our way to destiny, I command them now be broken in the name of Jesus. I command them now be broken in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare that whatever has held you back, you are free in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go and prosper in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I pray for open doors in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever has been delayed in your life, I command them now to come for speedily in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Whatever is hanging in the air that belongs to you, right here, right now, receive it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It is done in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Love those hands of Jesus. Hallelujah. We have to hear the word. Hallelujah. Let me get my thing. I'm sweating a bit. Get out your Bibles, please. If you don't have a Bible, come in front. Let me pray for you. The last time when we were doing prophecy here, I went home and I had my troubles. God said, "Do not preach the word." You always sleeping. I was begging. Say, God, have mercy. Oh Lord, I just thank you for tonight. You are a good God, for
Amen.
Real. We
Amen.
Celebrate you.
Amen.
You said in Isaiah 55:11 that as your word goeth forth, it will not go for a comeback for it.
Oh, yes.
As it goes forth, O Lord, let it begin to go to the foundation of their lives and let it take away everything there that is not of you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be thou glorified. Psalms 118 verse 24. You might not hear your name, you might hear your name after now, but every word, the Bible says that the word of God is as two-edged sword. So as I release the word, something is happening.
Amen.
You might not feel it, it might not be supernatural, but something is happening.
Amen.
When you come to church, you must always put in your mind that you cannot live the same. It's not possible.
Yes.
But it always comes with an expectation, with knowing what the word of God says. Moses went to the mountain, and when he came back with the glory of God. And he came back online and he began to release it. That's the same thing that happens when you come to church. You go back with their glory. And those things that have been a challenge before, you say it cannot happen again.
Amen.
I came back
Amen.
With power. I came back with dunamis.
Hallelujah.
So those things must go out of the way. That's what that's how it works. And what happens today is that many go to a restaurant and they say, chicken and chips, please. But when they come to church and they go home, they sleep. They shut their mouth. They go and eat a bite, go to sleep, and then they sleep. You hear them snoring. Does that make sense, huh? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Psalms 118, verse 24. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Now, therefore, if you believe in that verse, prophesy to yourself that after now it shall be celebration every day. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. After now it shall. Open your mouth and make those declarations. Father, in the name of Jesus, I declare and I declare to each and every one of them, after now it shall be celebration. 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 Day of their life, it shall be celebration. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Tonight I see iron doors broken down for your sake in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
That amen is too lame.
Amen.
We are in the month of July 2017 and many still take life casually. But yet, no evidence. Yet, no tangible evidence from January to July. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is not you I'm talking about. But I came out tonight in the power of the Holy Ghost to prophesy that as this word enters you now, there will be good news for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said there will be good news for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said there will be good news for you in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
She said, great man of God. There is no great man of God. What she meant was, man of God backed up by grace. Does that make sense? That's what she meant. So don't go somewhere. Say that man is a great man of God. There's no great man of God. There's only a man of God. There's only a woman of God who is backed up by
grace.
Hallelujah. Amen. If you hold this mic, the way you can manifest here, I will probably be jumping around. Does that make sense?
No.
So you're better than who is speaking. Carry yourself like that. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I don't mean the arrogant, but carry yourself that he that is in you is greater than he that is in the
world.
Carry yourself like that.
Yes.
God is saying here tonight that someone is a landlord, but you see them just walking like tenants. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
You must tell it. If he says you're a landlord, sir.
Amen.
Oh, yes.
If I say to you, go behind your house, there is diamond there. Go and dig. You waste time, you'll steal that diamond. Once I spoke it, that's a prophecy. You must go and dig.
Oh, yes.
If you don't dig, someone else will steal it. And if you go as soon as I speak and you dig, there's no diamond, call the police. They stole your diamond. That is God for you. God wants people who have a die-hearted passion for him. And what do I mean by passion? I say you are healed, you are healed. Not that you'll be healed tomorrow. No. At the spot, you are healed. It doesn't matter what you see, you are healed. But we don't move by sight, we move by faith. We move by the Spirit of the living God. Lift up your hands as we pray this prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, every arrow, every strong man from my father's house, from my mother's house, targeted at my focus now, I break their focus. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. Every strong man, whoever that has been assigned to target my focus, to distract me in any way, I break their focus now. 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 Thank you and thank you and thank you and thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying.
Amen.
Just keep receiving. After tonight, you will be tired of celebrations in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Celebration will be your middle name after now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't like that amen at all.
Amen.
I just heard this again now. That someone in here, you are trying to get land back home, you'll be favored in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Have you been in a situation where you go and buy something and the person say, don't worry, I'll do it for you free. Something that costs thousands of pounds. What is that? Favor. That will sweep for you this morning in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That amen is very lame.
Amen.
We should understand that the month of July, like I said, is the seventh month and is a month of perfection.
Amen.
The number seven is the number of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Friends, the first half of this year might have been rough for some of you. But the fact that you are alive, you are breathing, is a testimony that before the 31st of December 2017, there will be miracles left, right, center in your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The fact that God allowed you to see this day, this second half of the year, means that it will be celebrations in every area of your life in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
If your amen is louder, you're the one I'm talking to.
Amen.
You see footballers play, first half, they are winning them. And then they enter into the second half. And they turn things around. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Is someone getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
Oh, yes.
On a football field, it does not matter what happens in the first half. Even if you are losing, it matters what you do in the second half.
Yes.
That is why even, how do they call it? When it's 1-1, they give an extra time.
Yes.
They don't just give 15 minutes. They give 15 minutes for the first half again. They give 15 minutes for the second half again. This is very prophetic now, very true. So what am I saying? That it does not matter what may have happened to you in this first half of the year.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
But it matters what you do in the second half of the year.
Amen.
My God, some things are known for at the last minute, sir. The last second, you think they have lost it. It is a goal.
Amen.
It is a goal.
Amen.
There is a all I tell you today, go home and rejoice.
Amen.
This is what he told me yesterday. That's what I'm telling you now.
It does not matter who may have said in the first part of the year that you don't move forward.
It matters what you do now.
It matters what you do after now.
Yeah.
There is tremendous power in this place to change your life.
Amen.
Amen.
All you have to do after that is go to that business that was not working and say every good thing here is sold.
Amen.
Faith. Amen. Faith. It is still there, you are still looking at it. But you are declaring, by the glory that I've brought from this mountain, you could be sold. Don't think you are a fool. If I came here today, I saw nobody. Hey, service will work. I'm telling you the truth. Service will absolutely, I'll be talking and touching the chairs.
Amen.
So what you do after now matters a lot. God sent me tonight to tell someone not to be discouraged.
Amen.
Amen.
Not to fear.
Amen.
Not to remember the former things.
Amen.
Why? Because he is about to do a new thing.
Amen.
And he says, I should tell you that it shall spring forth.
Amen.
Isaiah 43, 18, 19. Remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I, the Lord, I am doing what? A new thing, and it shall spring forth. Do you not perceive it? My God, that's so powerful. Many are in church physically, they are at home spiritually. There is power to change their life, but they cannot perceive. He says he will do a new thing.
Amen.
Do you not perceive it? What does that mean? This message is only for those who can perceive it.
Hallelujah.
So is it that you faced disappointment in the first part of the year? God is saying, remember the Lord. Is it rejection you faced in the first half of the year? God says, remember the Lord. Is it stagnation? Have you been mocked? Have you been rejected? God is saying, remember them not. Because he is about to do a new thing. Touch your neighbor and say, remember not the former things. God is about to do a new thing.
God is about to do a new thing.
It shall not tarry, I tell you. Wait for it. It shall surely come to pass. Ezekiel said, Ezekiel 37:7, that's what I said, God said, I should tell you today. So I prophesied as I was commanded. And I was prophesying, there was a noise. My God. There was a rattling noise. And the bones came together. Ay, 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 ay.
Yeah.